is the last weekend of Ojar time. Next weekend is the first Sunday of Lent, and this coming Wednesday is Ash Wednesday. And I think to myself, a lot of times as we begin the season of Lent, I do my usual homily about the sacrament of reconciliation, and I will do that as we get towards the end of this homily. But I think the thing that's really impressive about all of these readings is the mercy and compassion of the Lord. In the first reading from Isaiah, Isaiah realizes that he's wicked, and the people in wisdom are all wicked. And yet notice that the Lord sends an angel to remember and touches his tongue. And at the end, he's forgiven. And the Lord says to him, I need somebody to go out and be a prophet. And he says, here I am, Lord, send me. Paul, in the second reading, realizes that what he did to the church, he persecuted the church. He was not a lover of the church. And then he had a conversion experience. And he recognized that because he felt the grace and the compassion and the mercy of the Lord in his life. And the Lord forgave him. And he then became one of the apostles proclaiming the kingdom of God. In our gospel passage this evening, it's filled with so many things that I could talk about. But the one thing that I'd like to just mention is the whole aspect of Peter. Peter's annoyed. He worked all night. He's tired. Jesus says to him, go out again and catch more fish. And Peter more or less says to him, you know, Lord, I've been out all night. I don't really want to do that, but I will, because you're asking. And as the story unfolds, you recognize he catches a lot of fish. And then Peter realizes that what he has done was wrong. And he goes to the Lord and says, you know, depart from me, I'm a sinful man. And the Lord says to him, don't worry about it, you're forgiven. And in the end, we know he becomes the first pope. Church. And so all three readings give us the opportunity to experience the compassion and the mercy of the Lord. And so as we begin the season of Lent, I'm going to ask you to somehow take that banner and recognize his merciful compassion in our lives. Pope Francis declared beginning of last December 8th and going to the end of November of this year, a year of mercy. Because I think for so many of us, we looked upon the Lord and we were taught that the Lord was there to really judge us. And Francis is trying to get us to look at the mercy of the Lord, the compassion of the Lord, the love he had for each and every one of us. And so I'd ask us to take up that battle as we move into the season of Lent. And so I'm going to mention about the sacrament of reconciliation. It is one of the seven sacraments. It does give grace. But I really believe it's one of those sacraments that we really don't like to go to. We just feel uncomfortable. And I know numerous people after I usually give this homily will say to me, I'll never come to you because you'll know what I look like. And then you'll always be thinking of the sins that I committed and I told you. I get that. But there's hundreds of other priests that you can go to avail yourself of the sacrament of reconciliation. But for those of you that have not been there in a while, I just want to run through the process. Whereas I'm just going to ask you to come up and just sit in this chair and not to say anything, I promise. All right? The reconciliation here is in the back of the church. And you have the option, when you come in the sacrament of reconciliation, either to kneel as you come through the door, I'm sitting behind the screen. That way you go anonymously. I don't know who it is, I just hear a voice. Or you can come in and sit across from me, like this. And the whole aspect of coming to the sacrament of reconciliation is, we all know we made mistakes. We all know that at times we fail. There are no necessities. And so we all recognize that we are sinful people and that we don't always do the best. And so the whole aspect of this particular sacrament is recognizing sorrow for what we've done, recognizing what we've done, and then asking the priest through the Lord to kind of bless us so that when we leave the reconciliation room, we begin anew. It's fresh. We start over. And so the first thing you have to decide before you win the reconciliation is, are you going to go anonymously or are you going to sit face to face? The choice is yours. And so if we're doing it face to face, you just start off by saying, bless me, Father, for I've sinned. It's been 3 years, 2 months, last week, whatever it is. If you can't remember the time, you can say it's been a long time or it's been a short period of time. That's up to you to kind of decide when was the last time you were in the sacrament of reconciliation. And then it's just talking about